First, you have to be convinced of the powers of goodness, that a good thing could be done. Most of the people, or almost all the people who are jealous, they don't have this. They are all connected. They are not, they, if you say that, you see here, there are so many people who are illiterate. Let us start a project where we will bring basic education to these people. They will say, oh, is it so easy? So many people have tried. It will never happen. They have this despondent attitude. Why? Because they are not convinced of goodness. Because they are thinking, they are convinced that their whole life is damned, and that they are nothing but specimens of damnation. And so they don't think, or they don't believe in anything that is good, or they don't believe in any hope of goodness. And the second quality which one needs is absence of jealousy and suspicion. When will you have absence of jealousy and suspicion? Only when you are convinced of goodness. When you are convinced of goodness, you will automatically not have jealousy and suspicion. Samsayatma pranashyati. In the Bhagavad Gita, it is said, a person who is suspicious comes to destruction, is destroyed. You don't have anything. Why? Because suspicion doesn't lead to anything. Swamiji says, why should the Hindu nation, with all its wonderful intelligence and other things, have gone to pieces? I would answer you, jealousy, he says. Jealousy. It's because of jealousy that the Hindu nation, which is actually India, we may not be able to call India today as Hindu nation, but India has gone into pieces with all its wonderful intelligence and all other cultural heritage and even other geographical advantages, everything. It has gone to pieces, smithereens. It has been blown into smithereens. Why? How? Because of jealousy. Never were there people more wretchedly jealous of one another, more envious of one another's fame and name than this wretched Hindu race. Take any institution, any family, any society, any small group, subgroup. It could be even two friends in India, and you will find jealousy. Two people can do well together in India as long as both of them are mediocre, as long as both of them have achieved nothing. But the moment a person achieves something, that another person becomes jealous of the first person. In any institution, this is the problem. So, never were there people more wretchedly jealous of one another. Swamiji says that they are wretchedly jealous, more envious of one another's fame and name than this wretched Hindu race. And if you ever come out in the West, the absence of this is the first feeling which you will see in the Western nations. A person is singing well in India. What happens? Oh, this person is singing. We don't know. This person may be morally corrupt. That is the comment you get in India. But the same person is singing, and not even singing, going to the West, but just sending some maybe CDs or something, or some audio files through internet, and the people there, they immediately say, wow, what a wonderful voice you have. You have such a talent. And this appreciation is there. That shows that it is a free nation.